Well, good morning, everyone. I got something interesting to share. Yesterday, I've made a lot of screenshots of opportunities that I found. I usually do this daily. And you can see here, Pimon has an interesting setup and BPET also. MNG, Zoom, and Mula. Unfortunately, most of them didn't reach the target. In most cases, I just wait until they get in the zone. And if they don't, then, well, that's too bad. So, actually, this morning, Pimon reached an influential zone. So let me explain it for a bit. As you can see right here, Pimon has went through a important range. And it bounced a bit. So it dipped twice into it, then had a small bounce, and now it's consolidating a little bit above it. I already bought some here. I was awake too late, so I woke up somewhere around here, and that caused me to have a little bit higher risk. You know, if you would enter right here, risk would be roughly around 5%, but because I entered here, it's more like 7%. So it's not that bad. That's why I did decide to enter. Now, I also want to talk about more interesting zones, especially for Pimon. Like, you would probably say that this is also an interesting zone. And of course, this here is an interesting zone. Well, you can say this is probably the most interesting zone, but so once it actually gets there, I would really, you know, go all in at this point. But it's also funny to see that if you look at this zone, for example, you have to look at it like this. So price consolidates here for a little while. And after consolidation, it shoots up pretty significantly. Okay, so all the people that were that realized when price was a little bit higher that they should have bought, the next time that the price will visit that price again, they will step in. And the more people that were interested in buying, the bigger the bounce will when it revisits that support, right? So this is not a very interesting zone, not like this one. And that is because this zone has already been retested before. What it means when it retests is that some of the people who wanted to buy actually got filled again here. And that reduces the amount of interest as soon as it retests for the second time. So of course, this retest was the first time when it did it, so it saw a nice bounce. But then when it comes back again, which is around here, you see that there's not much of a response here. So you would rather avoid these already tested zones. The next one here where I entered is a untested zone, actually, because when you see that the price here took off and actually quite significantly also, because even there it stalled for just quite a bit and then continued up. So this zone is pretty strong and untested. So there's a big likelihood that when price comes back here, it will do a pullback. And of course, the next important zone is this one. This is like a major zone because it's also visible on the 12-hour or the daily, even. And usually those zones are even stronger. So here you could easily see a bounce of 60%, 80%, but those will also take a longer period of time. And yeah, and this is also a very good opportunity. So, I mean, if I could win a solid 20% on this one, that would be good in my books. So that's about it. I'll check back when there's some interesting movement. Okay, guys, checking back in. I bought here, and right after that there was a small dip back in the zone. That is something that happens quite often, and most cases it will it will not break the support, but in some cases it will. So, you know, when you're looking at this and you're seeing it dip back almost near the bottom of the range, then it is quite scary, and it takes some time to get over that. You know, you really need to trust your system, and once you really know the statistics of your system, then it's much easier to deal with these kind of things. And and usually I'll always put a certain line on my chart, or I write it down like this, so that mentally I am already prepared to sell if price does something, trespasses a certain price, or crosses a condition. So I think that's really important, because then you can never lose more than you expected to lose. But in this case, actually, the price reacted very well and is showing a lot of buying volume and pressure. So that's really nice. I wanted to check in because I am planning to sell a little bit here. You know, in most cases, this zone here will start some sort of small uptrend. So it generally goes a little bit past the first resistance, but in some rare cases, like between 15 and 30%, it won't. It will just reach the first resistance, and from there a breakdown. Usually you could see something like this, a second try, and then it will stay a little bit in the range. And usually when this happens, I back out already, because this is not the strength that I'm looking for. You know, after this, something like this usually will happen. And I am mainly interested in like the first time it touches the zone, and then I want to see, you know, I want to see it go up and not come back down after it went up. You know, so it can go down a little bit, but it shouldn't really go back in the range again. I don't really like to see that, and I'll get out. So then how much should you sell here? Well, because it doesn't go down very often after it touches this resistance, so it doesn't make sense to sell a lot here. It's just a safety precaution. So generally I would sell, you know, between 10 and 30%, depending on how confident I am that it will break this resistance. And well, if you really know very well what the percentage is that it crosses the first resistance or not, then you could even calculate much more accurate how much you should sell here. but it should be like in the ballpark of 10 to 20%. So I'm going to sell, let's say 15%. 7, 8, 4 times 15, 117. Change that to BUSD. It's much easier to use Binance USD. It's a super stable coin, just like USD Tether. So I might even just keep the BUSD in my account. Don't really have to transfer it over to Binance anymore. So let's do that. Okay, so here's my cell. Excellent. All right, so I will check back in when price either approaches around this resistance here. We actually have this huge resistance right here, or when it comes back into the range. All right, so I just sold my last PMons. So just to recap, the purple area was the zone where I entered, and as you can see, it really did a great bounce, but it didn't come very far here. So first, I wish I had bought in the range, but well, because I wasn't on time, I had to buy a little bit higher. Afterwards, I did get the dip, but that actually doesn't happen that often, so it's not something that I account for, and it's okay. Next, I sold at the first resistance here, and let it continue. And it didn't really go very far, not as far as I had hoped. It still could go further, of course. But I saw some really big sells coming in, and it was pretty close. I mean, there was a big spike. You know, sometimes you get these big buys, big spikes, and I wasn't really there when it happened. You know, also too bad that there's no ability to set limit sells or limit orders, as you could potentially catch these spikes. And so I planned on selling at this price here. I was happy with the profits that I got. It could have been much more if I had entered here in the range, but I mean, that's a different thing. And there was a small problem with selling when the price was here. It kind of stick around at this price, at least the visual or the interface showed that, but it wasn't really true. The price was already lower, but I didn't really know that. So I sold here thinking I was selling at 12.6. But when the sell came through, it was actually 12.2, something like that. So I also lost basically or gave back 3% profit almost there. But yeah, okay, that shit happens. You know, at least happy that we've made some profit in this trade. And let's see how much it is exactly. So I've already deposited it. So, 8,277 euros. That means we've got a win of almost 10% for this trade. So, that's decent. Wish it was more, but let's hope for more luck in the next trade.